Good morning, children. I welcome you all once again in the chemistry class. Today, I will start the chemical properties of metals. Under that, today I will take on the two properties, that is the electropositive character of metals and reaction of metals with oxygen. After that, I will discuss some questions based on the above two topics. Chemical properties of metals. Under that, the first chemical property, that is electropositive character of metals. Children, metals has tendency to lose one or more electrons, and with the loss of one or more electrons, it can form positively charged particles. And these positively charged particles thus form, they are known as cations, or also we can call them as basic radicals. And here the tendency to lose the electron to form positively charged particles, it depends upon the reactivity of the metal. The metal which is highly reactive can lose the electron easily, whereas the one which one is least reactive can lose the electron with more difficulties. So the tendency of losing the electron of a metal atom decides its reactivity. So here sodium, as you know, sodium electronic configuration is 2-8-1. That means it has one electron in its outermost shell, and hence sodium can lose only one electron, and with the loss of one electron, sodium will form Na plus ion. Likewise, potassium electronic configuration is 2-8-8-1. That means it again has one electron, so that it can lose only one electron to form K plus ion. But calcium, electronic configuration of calcium is 2882. So what is the valence electron? Yes, the valence electron of calcium is 2. Hence, it can lose 2 electrons to form calcium Ca 2 plus ion. Likewise, aluminium 283, 3 electrons it can lose to form Al 3 plus ions. So, the more easily an atom lose the electron, more electropositive, or one new term I can say here, metallic character. The electropositive character of metal, we can also call it as a metallic character. Reaction of metals with oxygen. Children, metals react with oxygen to form metallic oxide. And these metallic oxides are basic in nature. The vigor of reaction with oxygen depends upon the chemical reactivity of the metals. The metals such as potassium, sodium and calcium. These three metals react with oxygen at room temperature to form corresponding oxides, such as potassium reacts with oxygen to form potassium oxide. Sodium reacts with oxygen to form sodium oxide. And children, these two metals, that is sodium oxide, sodium and potassium, the vigorness of these two metals are such a high that these two metals reacts with atmospheric oxygen, and when they react with atmospheric oxygen, they catch fire. And due to this, burning of potassium and sodium at room temperature with oxygen, in presence of oxygen, these two metals always stored in kerosene oil to prevent them from moisture, air and carbon dioxide. Regarding the moisture and carbon dioxide, I will deal with another chemical reaction. Now, the calcium can stored in a container, airtight container, because the calcium oxide form, that is not, the reaction is not such vigorous as case of the potassium and sodium. Now children, come to magnesium. Magnesium, aluminium and zinc, these three metals can react with oxygen on heating. Magnesium reacts with oxygen. At room temperature, it will form a thin layer of magnesium oxide. And children, the magnesium oxide, this layer does form, prevent further reaction of magnesium. But when we heat magnesium, on heating, magnesium reacts with oxygen to form white ash. And this white ash is of magnesium oxide, powder form. Here you will get the magnesium oxide in powder form. Likewise, aluminium. When aluminium metal is exposed to air, children, it will form a thin layer of aluminium oxide. And this thin layer of aluminium oxide prevents further reaction of aluminium. But when we take freshly prepared aluminium powder and pass hot air or oxygen gas over it, it reacts chemically to form powder aluminium oxide. Iron, when we pass hot air through red hot iron, okay children, then iron chemically reacts with oxygen to form ferric oxide. Last, copper. As you already know, copper is one of the least reactive metals. So the reaction of copper with oxygen is quite difficult. So copper does not react with oxygen at room temperature. There is no reaction of copper with oxygen at room temperature. However, when we heat it strongly, on strong heating, the copper can react with oxygen to form a thin black layer of cupric oxide. Children, this thin black layer of cupric oxide does form over the copper metal can be removed by treating the copper oxide layer with hydrogen gas. When cupric oxide layer is treated with hydrogen, the copper oxide turns back to copper. Here copper oxide get reduced to copper by hydrogen with the formation of water. Now, just now we have learned, children, metallic oxides are basic in nature. How can we confirm that metallic oxides are basic in nature? In order to confirm that metallic oxides are basic in nature, you just take the metallic oxide, dissolve it in water. When you add water in the metallic oxide and the corresponding compound form, that is potassium gives potassium hydroxide. If you take any metallic oxide, that will form metal hydroxide. And when you bring a red litmus paper in contact with the aqueous solution of this hydroxide, and if it turns red to blue, that confirms the oxide is basic in nature. So here potassium forms potassium hydroxide, calcium gives calcium hydroxide, and this calcium hydroxide solution turns red litmus blue. Likewise, magnesium oxide forms magnesium hydroxide, and this magnesium hydroxide again turns red litmus blue. So through this we can confirm the metallic oxides are basic in nature. Again, children, here, if you take dry form of this oxide, dry form of potassium hydroxide, calcium oxide and magnesium oxide, and if you bring dry red litmus paper, there will be no change in the color. That means these oxides can show their basic property when they are dissolved in water, or we can say in their aqueous solution. Now, two more points here. The oxides of sodium, when dissolved in water, will form sodium hydroxide. Potassium gives potassium hydroxide. And these two hydroxides are known as alkalis. Clear? Alkalis, they are bases, at the same time they are known as alkalis because they are highly soluble in water. So the bases which are soluble in water are known as alkalis. Here calcium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide, aluminium and zinc, they are base but they are not considered as alkali because they are partially soluble in water. Now chemically, how can you show that metallic oxides are basic in nature? Here, one point always keep in your mind, basic oxides are always react with acid. Basic oxides react with acid to form salt and water. For example, potassium oxide. Here it is a basic oxide, reacts with HCl, which is an acid, to form potassium chloride and water. Likewise, calcium oxide, which is a basic oxide, reacts with sulfuric acid to form calcium sulfate and water. Magnesium oxide, again it is a basic oxide, reacts with hydrochloric acid to form magnesium chloride and water. So this point is also very much important, that basic oxides always react with acid to form salt and water. Now next, amphoteric nature of metallic oxide. Just now we have learned metallic oxides are basic in nature. But children, there are some metallic oxides which are amphoteric in nature. What we have learned just, basic oxides react with acid to form salt and water. But when you are talking about the amphoteric oxide or amphoteric nature of metallic oxide, such oxides can react with both acid as well as base to form salt and water. So when the metallic oxide reacts with acid, then the nature of the metallic oxide is considered as a basic nature. But the same metallic oxide, when react with base to form salt and water, then the metallic oxide nature is acidic in nature. That means here the metallic oxide acts as acidic oxide. Two good examples of amphoteric oxides are aluminium oxide and zinc oxide. When aluminium oxide reacts with base NaOH, here the aluminium oxide acts as an acidic oxide and the salt form will be NaAlO2, that is sodium aluminate and water. Second, when the aluminium oxide reacts with acid, that is hydrochloric acid, here the aluminium oxide acts as a basic oxide. Here it is showing its basic property. In first case, it is showing its acidic property because here it reacts with base, and in second case, it reacts with acid to form aluminium chloride and water. Next, zinc oxide. Here, zinc oxide as well amphoteric in nature. When zinc oxide reacts with sodium hydroxide, here sodium hydroxide is a base, as zinc oxide reacts with base and hence it shows its acidic nature to form salt, that is sodium zincate, Na2ZnO2. ZnO2, children, this is the symbol for zincate whose valency is 2, whereas aluminate AlO2 valency is 1. Clear? So zinc oxide, when it reacts with base, it acts as an acidic oxide. The same zinc oxide, when reacts with acid, here it shows its basic nature. So zinc oxide, when reacts with HCl, it will form zinc chloride and water. Now answer the following questions. Question number 1. When the powder of a common metal is heated in an open china dish, its color turns black. However, when hydrogen gas is passed over the hot black substance formed, it regains the original color. Based on this information, answer the following questions. Which type of chemical reaction takes place in each of the two given steps? So in the first step, children, a metal reacts with oxygen to form or turns to black color. So just I am giving you here reaction of metal with oxygen to form metal oxide. So you have to identify this. In second case, the oxide, metal oxide does form. When we pass hydrogen gas, it turns to metal with the formation of water. Watch the video carefully. automatically you will get answer from there. Now question B part of the same. Name the metal initially taken in the powder form and write the balanced chemical equation for both of these reactions. I hope you can able to write the answer for both A and B just after observing the video carefully. Now question number 2. An element reacts with oxygen to give a compound with high melting point. This compound is also water soluble. The element is likely to be calcium, carbon, silicon, iron. Try to give answer yourself, children. It is also there in the video. Question number 3. Identify the oxides from the following which turn moist red litmus into blue. Just children, I am giving you hints here. The metallic oxides can turn moist red litmus into blue. So among the following you identify the metallic oxide and then you justify your answer by reaction it with water. Question number 4. Why is zinc oxide called amphoteric oxide? So for this, first you define the amphoteric oxide, then you write down two equations. In first equation, you show the basic nature of the zinc oxide, and in second equation, you show the acidic nature of the zinc oxide. And then second part, name another amphoteric oxide. Question number 5. What are alkalis? Give two examples of alkalis. Question number 6. Why are metals good conductors of electricity while non-metals are not? Dear children, write all these answers in your classwork copy and keep it ready. Anytime I will ask you to show your copy in WhatsApp group. Thank you.